Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about how to generate PWM pulse in Simulink MATLAB. So thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click the bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. To start with the MATLAB simulation of PWM generator in MATLAB Simulink. So just go to Simulink and then open blank model, and then next you have to click this Simulink browser and then use repeating sequence. So now we are going to see about how to generate sinusoidal pulse width modulation. So for that I'm going to use repeating sequence. And I'm going to use sinusoidal waveform. So I'm going to take the sinusoidal waveform frequency, amplitude is 0.9, and then frequency is 2 pi f. So I'm going to consider 2 pi 2 hertz, right? So just this is just for example. So I'm going to consider frequency is 2 hertz, and then I'm going to create the triangular wave. So this is the triangular, right? Initially it will be 0, and then it comes to 1, and then comes to -1, or else you can write like that also. So -1 1 -1, okay. So you have to fix the time for this -1 +1 -1. So here the output I'm going to take -1 1 -1, and then the starting time I'm going to consider 0, and then I'm going to take 0.02 0.04. So here the frequency is 1 divided by 0.04, so just 25 hertz, okay. So this is for example I'm going to consider, okay. So the triangular frequency is 25 hertz, and then sinusoidal frequency is 2 hertz, okay, for generating the sinusoidal PWM pulse or PWM generator. So next I'm going to use relational operator. So this is nothing but comparator. Okay, so we are going to compare that sinusoidal waveform with the triangular waveform for generating the pulse. Okay, so here I'm going to use greater than or equal to symbol relation. So I'm going to connect this. So next I'm going to use scope to measure the input and the output. So number of scope I'm going to take, number of port, input port I'm going to take 2, and also I'm going to use max. So to max the two inputs, that means sinusoidal input and triangular input. So that going to be given to first input for the scope. Now here I'm going to give the output of relational operator to the second input of the scope. So next I'm going to model configuration, and then I'm going to change the maximum step size equal to only for -5, and then go to simulation stepping option. So here I'm going to consider the maximum step size is 2 lakh. Okay, here you can see that the frequency of sinusoidal is 2 hertz. Okay, so that mean 2 hertz means the time will be 1 divided by 2, so which is 0.5. so here I'm going to consider the total cycle will be 2 cycles, so I'm going to fix the time equal to 1. So now I'm going to configure the scope. So here we have number of input port is 2, So I'm going to take two number of layout. Now I'm going to simulate this model. The next time I'm going to change the style of the scope in order to get the clear detail of the waveforms. So now we can see that waveform clearly. So here we have take greater than or equal to, right? So here you can see that when the sinusoidal is greater than this triangular wave, okay, the sine wave, right? Here you can see that the value is minus 1, right? So the sine wave is greater than this triangular, so that's why we are getting plus output. After this point, right, the triangle is having higher amplitude than the sinusoidal, so that's why the output will be zero. Okay, so after this point, the sine wave having higher amplitude than triangular, so that's why we are getting that mean plus one output, right? So here you can see that the amplitude, the first pulse width will be changed, it depends upon the crossing point of these, the triangular and the sinusoidal. Okay, so you can see that the pulse width here is very less, but here the pulse width is very high because and the crossing point from this point to this point, it have a long time, right? So that's why the pulse width of this waveform going to be changed according with the amplitude of sinusoidal and the triangular. Okay, so this is the output of the sinusoidal PWM generator. Just we are comparing the sine wave with the triangular, so and we are generating the pulse width, right? And the pulse width will be vary according with the amplitude of the sine wave and the triangular wave. So if you want to generate for a Hertz bridge, right, so we need four pulses, right? So just we go to use same relational operator and triangular wave, and then you have to use gain block here, right? Gain, and just you would connect this gain with sinusoidal and change the sign, okay, minus one. And now I'm going to connect this and this one. So I'm going to open this two scope, right? Now we can you can see the results of two waveforms. You can see here, right, the pulse width going to be changed. Here you can see that difference, right? The pulse width going to be changed different, right? Here you can see that the pulse width is very wide, right? But here you can see that the pulse width is very low, right? That means because we are inverted the sine wave with the 180 degree phase shift, right? That means if we are going to use this the sinusoidal PWM for drive the Hertz bridge inverter, right? So we need to generate four pulses, right? So for that we have to do like that, right? You have to use the normal sinusoidal from start from zero, and then it will take this kind of waveform, and then another waveform will be start from zero, but both are having 180 degree phase shift. Okay, so this is the way you are generating the pulse for this Hertz bridge inverter. Okay, and then you can take inverse for this, okay, by using NOT gate. Okay, and then you can take inverse for this pulse by using NOT gate, and then you can use this pulse for that Hertz bridge inverter. Okay, Next, so this is for sinusoid, that means this is if this pulse width modulation is to for drive the bridge inverter. If suppose we are going to drive the DC to DC converter, so we need to use another kind of method. That means just we got to use same triangular wave. Here I'm going to change the amplitude of triangular is 0, 1, 0. So it's like unipolar PWM, right? And I'm going to take this and then I'm going to use constant block, right? So here I'm going to use constant. So here the I'm going to put the duty cycle is 0.5. And then I'm going to use scope to measure the output of input and output, right? So now I'm going to simulate this one. Now you can see that I used the duty cycle is 0.5, right? So that's why the pulse width will be equal for on time and off time. Okay, if suppose I'm going to change the pulse width equal to 0.9. So that means you can see the variation now. You can see that on time will be having 90% pulse width and 10% is known as off time. So 90% on time and 10% off time. So now I'm going to change the duty cycle equal to 0.1. And you can see that. So 10% on time, 90% off time. So based upon duty cycle, right? So here you have to fix the on time, off time. That means it depends upon this, the duty cycle value, right? So this kind of PWM generation concept can be used in the DC-DC converter control. Okay. So this is a basic about PWM generator in MATLAB simulation block. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click the bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much. Bye bye.